Hey, what's up, world? It's your boy, G-Shrimp, everybody's favorite baby daddy, voice of the street, man. And today we in, we go be in L.A. with it, y'all. All the way in Hollywood, y'all. In nice neighborhoods, man. It just goes to show you, it don't matter where you live at, man, what you doing. When death come knocking on your door, it's that. Like the people say in Chicago, when it's that, it's that. Now, I'm going to be telling y'all the story of the two models that come up missing damn near the same time, and they died basically the same way. Now, if this ain't a coincidence, I'm talking about it is, it don't get no closer than that. Hit that like button before we get started, man. Hit that like button. I'm going to give you time to do that. Also, you people just tuning in, hit that subscribe button if you ain't subscribed to the channel. We're on the road to trying to get to 20,000, y'all. So hit that subscribe button. I'd like to welcome all my people over here at Spotify. If you're tuning in from podcast, driving all around the world, I appreciate you. Now, check this out, y'all. We going to be telling you the story, man. And I'm going to let y'all see some of the news clipping of two models, African-American models. African-American black women, y'all. Two females come up missing. One of them is 32, the other one is 31. They both were models, y'all. You would not believe this. Both of them come up missing and come up dead in their own apartment. Let's start with the second one who come up missing. Nicole Kotz. Her name is Nicole Kotz. She come up missing, right? They call her Nikki. Now, she was found in her house, y'all. She had a date. She was found Friday, September the 8th. That's when they found her. They did a well-being check. They couldn't find her. And she was found dead in her apartment. Looked like she had had a fight. Now, this is the one I believe they said had a date. She told people she had a date and she was going to be going out, and then she went off the radar. They didn't hear nothing from them. The guy must have attacked her in the house and raped her or whatever. She tried to fight him off because when they found her, her leg was in the kicking position. The last thing, her leg, that means she tried to kick him, and when he choked her out, her leg was still up in the air, and it just stayed like that. And he probably strangled around and rigor mortis set in, and that leg was still up there. So you can tell she was trying to fight for her life. And then, you know, a lot of time it'd be other things going on too. Like I heard her, some of her body parts was missing. So that means people be selling her their organs and shit. So they'll kill somebody and they make big money off the bottom. You know, they make big money off the body parts, right? And the best way to do that, you can lure a model out. You call her and tell her, hey, I want to hire you. I need you to come by yourself. And you can get her to any location you want her at. You know, now in this case, she was at home. You know, so this here, the guy came in like he wanted to date her, right? So now, like I say, that happened September the 8th. Then they found another one, y'all, September the 12th. Her name was Melissa. They found Melissa the same way in her house, y'all. Found her in her house. She was dead. But guess what? They found the one I just said, the second one, they found her first and found the first one last, y'all. Ain't that something? They didn't even notice this woman was missing. She had been missing all that time. Then they find the second one and then double back and find the first one. And they like, damn. You know, both of them in their own house and they deceased, y'all. They in their own house. One was found, like I say, September the 12th, y'all. That's crazy. This woman was beaten so bad, she had to have a closed casket. She had to have a closed casket. And this the one that had a leg kicked up, y'all. They said one had a leg kicked off, so that was the first one. They said she was one on the date, y'all. She was the one on the date, you know, and that's crazy. That, ladies, you got to watch who you dating, and then all I can say is be safe. Because you got to take a chance with love when you're trying, but you know, you got to have some stuff like shit like this laying around, you know, just in case. You don't know what these guys gonna be on. And you never know. Guys, they slip roofies in your drink and they'll drug you. You know, you'd be lucky if you to get raped. You'd be lucky to get raped. You know? Hell, because they killing people and they taking them for their body parts out here. I'm gonna let y'all listen to some of this and then I'll come back with my thoughts on what I think, y'all. I'm gonna let y'all run through about 4 or 5 of these. Let's start with this one right here.
I'm scared. I just want to be by myself. You do not have to be scared. You can get along with us.
We are going to celebrate. Now at 6, a second model has been found dead in her apartment in downtown LA. And this happened just days before another model was found dead in her nearby apartment. Tonight, we have the latest on both of those cases. Hello, everybody. Welcome to the News at 6. I'm Rick Chambers.
And I'm Corrine Winter. A deepening mystery tonight as we learn of the death of a model in downtown L.A., the second in a matter of days.
Yeah, both of them found lifeless in their own apartments. Tonight, in a story you'll see only on 5, the mother of one of those victims is speaking out. Let's go to Chris Wolf. He joins us live from Hollywood now. He's got details on all of this. Chris?
That's right, Rick, Corrine, what a mystery this is. Two young models discovered dead in their luxury apartments in downtown Los Angeles just days apart. One case is considered a homicide. The other one right now is considered suspicious, undetermined. Are they related? This is a story you will see only on 5.
It's senseless, and I want some answers because my daughter is gone. It is not fair. I want everybody to find out who did this to her. She shouldn't be gone. But we need to know. We need to know what happened.
Family members of a beautiful young model who recently discovered her dead in her downtown Los Angeles apartment are crying foul play. And explain they are frustrated at the lack of answers and information coming from investigators. 32-year-old Nicole Coates, known as Nikki, told friends she had a date on Friday, September 8th. That's the last they heard from her. She didn't answer calls or texts during the weekend, so her father and aunt visited her luxury apartment 2 days later, located at 8th and Grand. That's when they made the gut-wrenching discovery.
I couldn't recognize her.
You feel there was some level of violence with this death?
Yes, I do.
Mm-hmm. You believe it was murder?
I believe it was. I really do. One of her legs was up in the air in a kicking position. That's not nobody that's just laid in their bed and died. Mm-hmm. I don't know who she went out with. What transpired there, I have no idea. But I'm going to find out. So if you're out there, you're going to get caught. You're messing with the wrong person.
The L.A. County Coroner's Office says the case of Nicole Coates is open and the cause of death deferred. That means the cause is undetermined and further investigation is needed. However, Nikki's suspicious death is alarmingly similar to another recent case. During a welfare check for concerned family members, police discovered the body of 31-year-old model and real estate agent Melissa Mooney on Tuesday afternoon. She was inside her luxury apartment, Sky at Bunker Hill, on South Figueroa Street. The LAPD is not releasing any details, but confirms detectives are investigating the young woman's death as a homicide. Family and friends are devastated, and neighbors are extremely concerned. The family of Nikki Coates is watching that case closely.
I feel myself is a predator loose.
Anyone with information should contact the LAPD. We'll have much more later on tonight. For now, reporting live in Compton, Chris Wolf, KTLA 5 News.
Wolfie, thank you for that.
Compton, speaking of Compton, y'all, shout out to my man Zoe out there, man. His name is Zoe. He's staying bumped, and he told me if I come out there, he got me, man. He said, I got you, G, come out there. Bumped his name, the brother said, Zula? Zula, that's the name, Zula.
City of LA so far this year, every one of them, of course, a tragedy. Now, family,
shout out to him, I'm bumped.
Seeking answers to what happened on the fifth floor of this apartment building. Things were going well for 31-year-old Melissa Mooney. She just gotten her real estate license, working for a Beverly Hills firm. Last month, had moved into her first apartment in this fenced, guarded downtown L.A. high-rise, where according to photos on the company's website, studios, one and two bedrooms, range from $1,950 to $3,500, and it was billed as resort-style living. But then, worries when Melissa's sister Jordan and their mom couldn't reach her.
You spent all that money to die in a fancy apartment.
Usually she answers, oh, like, you know, it was just a little concerning. And my mom, she just was just super worried.
The family's worst fears came true Tuesday after they insisted on an in-person welfare check. Police found Melissa's body. Her sister says her phone and computer were missing.
I feel like she was around people who didn't see her value, because ain't no way this should have happened. Not to my sister. Not someone as kind and as loving as she is. Not someone who's so nurturing and making sure that everyone is okay. I'm numb. I feel like I'm just going through the days. I haven't really slept, so I'm just really trying to figure out what happened to my sister.
Not much from the LAPD yet. Homicide investigators telling Fox 11 it was determined that Miss Mooney was murdered inside her apartment. The cause of death is pending post-mortem examination. They're requesting the public's help with any information. So the sister tells me, Alex and Christine, that the new neighbors of Melissa saw her coming back to the apartment last Thursday with friends. They saw the friends leave, but she didn't. If you have any info, the LAPD Central Bureau Homicide phone number will be on our website, foxla.com. Live downtown, I'm Phil Schumann, Fox 11 News.
Now, one of them girls they put in the refrigerator, y'all. They came, they say her damn icebox was missing, her laptop, and the phone.
Yeah, there's been growing concern across the community with no answers, but today at least we're getting one of those answers, but still very few details. Two models found dead, both in their early 30s, living only a mile apart in downtown LA. The second model found just 2 days later. Eerily similar, it might seem, but after days of questions and uncertainty, police are now saying there's no evidence, at least so far, to believe the two deaths are related. That is the only new detail involving the investigation that police are willing to release more than a week later. This after family members and the community began demanding answers in fear of a serial predator.
Can you talk a little bit about the two homicides that in downtown, the two young ladies, any information, black young ladies, which is really disturbing. I don't know if there's any information you can provide the public and us.
Yeah, at this point, I want to respect the investigation, the efforts in determining the circumstances of those deaths. And I will update that, meaning I'll give greater detail in the coming days.
Families and the community beyond frustrated with no answers into the mysterious deaths of two young women. The mother of Nicole Coates taking her story to the media demanding answers.
I'm heartbroken and it's killing us. I'm devastated.
Nicole Coates was discovered inside her apartment on 8th and Grand. Her family had not heard from her for 2 days. Police will only say that this is a death investigation. But they have said Melissa Mooney's death was in fact a homicide. They say she was killed in her Bunker Hill high-rise.
Money.
And as you heard from the chief, LAPD is being tight-lipped with these investigations and are not releasing any further information for now. We also reached out to the coroner's office and they would not comment on either death. We are live in downtown LA. Jennifer McGraw, KTLA 5 News.
I'm just talking a job that...
Let me explain something to y'all. A lot of times, y'all be thinking, the police, oh, they won't tell us nothing. They doing this, they doing that. They hold back information for a reason. See, the police hold back information. Therefore, whenever they talking to people, when they be investigating this shit, they might put something in the paper and they'll leave something out. Like, let's say I go kill somebody, y'all, and I get away with it. And they say a person had on a mask. But they don't say I had on a mask with something written on the side. So, words might come up and then they talk about, oh yeah, the guy had a mask on and, you know, he strangled the woman and woo, however they put it together. And then you get somebody in the room and he said, but I don't own no mask with nothing on the side of it. And they say, what the fuck? We didn't say it was nothing on the side of the mask. We said the motherfucker had a mask on. What makes you think it was something on the side of the mask? Guilty conscience, let shit out. Like, I just heard some other people talking about something, you know. People be trying to be so real, these rappers and shit. And he was speaking on somebody got shot. He said the nigga died in that big ass coat. Now, only a motherfucker who pulled up on the nigga and shot him might know he had on a big ass coat. And the police, everybody else just don't, they don't know. But you putting shit like that, you letting people know, they call that a clue. You letting people know, you know a little bit more about the case than you should know. Because all that is, now some of that shit ain't in the paper. And the police do not give all the information out. You see, we watched 3-4 different news clips, y'all. And all of them had something different. All of them had something different. That's because that's how they want it. They didn't tell you that lady leg was caught up from fighting somebody off. And if you notice, they ruled one of them a homicide and the other one undetermined. They ruled it suspicious. See, but the person with the leg up, yeah, they know she was fighting somebody off. And that's probably the same one who went on the date, too. But this other one, it's kind of suspicious, but they're not for sure. Now, all the news clip, I didn't hear them say nothing about organ donor, but I heard on another one where they did say something about they believe these women were used for their body parts, organ donors, y'all. Let me tell you something. They doing a lot of kidnapping, y'all. Kids are coming up missing. Grown folks and everything. They doing everything from sex trafficking to organ donations. They stealing you. They will steal you, kill you, and sell all your body parts. You know how much a motherfucker person is worth about my size? Maybe worth about a good $50,000. Shit, they figure we can get a heart, we can get the lungs, we can get his eyes, his ears, and they sell all that. They might come up with $50,000, $60,000, probably more than that. It depends. They might even get a whole $100 out you. So hell, they figure the people who've been killing people for free be like, shit, I might as well start killing and getting paid. But you go kill the women, y'all. That's just so sad, you know, that these women got caught up like that, you know, and man, I feel sorry for them. That's why, ladies and gentlemen, I be telling you, when you're in the relationship, ladies, when your man say, hey, babe, call me when you get in the house, be considerate and pick that phone up. Baby, I'm at home. All right. You know what I mean? That's why we ask y'all questions and shit like, call me when you get home. It ain't to clock your time or to see if you went somewhere. Nobody care nothing about that. I just want to make sure you made it home safely, period. You know, and ladies, when your man say some shit like, hey, baby, I'm on my way to work. See you later on. Hey, baby, you know, if I don't never see you again, you know I love you, right? Don't say that. No, all you're supposed to do is say, yeah, I love you too, babe. Because he could pull right off the block and get hit by a bus. get hit by a bus, he can get hit by a train, bullets will catch his ass. It's all kind of ways to die. 6 million ways to die, they say. Choose one. I'm not choosing not now, goddamn it, because I'm not trying to die. It's going to be 6 million ways to die, 6 million ways and one ways to stop from dying. That's me. You feel me? That's me. I'm going to be the motherfucker trying to stop from dying. And you ain't going to kill nobody that's fucking with me. That's my wife, friend, cousin, anybody. I don't care. Dog, goldfish, parrot, anything. Hands off, bro. Hit that like button, y'all. Subscribe to the channel. One of my subscribers said, I like your content, but I couldn't hardly hear you with the mask on. Well, I appreciate you, sister, but I got the mask on for a reason. Maybe you're not a G-Shrimp fan. You ain't been watching the show in a while. This is going to be a surprise when I take my mask off. I know you want to see what's under the mask. You'll see. Don't worry. Don't worry. It's coming real soon, y'all. It's coming real soon. But I'm starting to get fond of my little mask, so... You know, y'all, I might even stretch out another week. Eat your heart out, trench nose, because my mask looks sharper than his. Yeah, my shit, everything I have be fly. I try to keep it like that anyway. Anyway, y'all, I just wanted to let y'all see a little something, you know, because I know y'all be wanting to see the GC, what I'm doing. I be laid back. I be taking days off sometime, you know. I got to with what I'm going through, for real, but when I can talk... And get y'all information, I will, you know. Also, with the takeoff thing, I was looking some more into that, right? Would you believe the motherfucker takeoff murderer, they just gave this motherfucker house arrest, took him off house arrest. Now he out on bond, free, walking around. I'm like, wow, really? Y'all just starting to do the most, huh? And the mama... is suing the place where Takeoff got killed at. Might as well get that money. Might as well. A lot of people be like, oh, it ain't about the money. And then, no, it ain't even about the money. It's some accountability, period. If you can get it back, because trust me, that boy was going to make more than $1 million if he stayed alive. So that ain't nothing for them to pay her $1 million. To pay her $1 million. The coolest motherfucker in the group is the one that died. Ain't that something? You know, that's crazy. And then I told you how much of an insult it sounds to see, you know, Offset on there talking this shit. You know, he got left on the block here, porta potty. All that shit rubbed me so long. I want to say, man, we'll sit your ass down, man. Straight up all that capping, man. Your people still dead, homie. Y'all ain't slid or did. No, I ain't heard nothing y'all did. All that talk, motherfucker talking about Atlanta going down to Houston. Them motherfuckers ain't went down there yet. They ain't went down there yet. But I guarantee you, Duke the Jeweler people went down there. Oh, yeah, I got confirmation they was down there. Asking questions and trying to get to the bottom of some of that shit. Now, I don't know how much crashing they did or whatever, but I do know his people was in town asking about his property and his merchandise. Because Duke the Jeweler had a lot of jewelry on him that night, y'all, that mysteriously walked away. Plus, he had a bag of money on him. All that just walked away. And another thing, you know, remember the lady that went over there, y'all, to Mexico, and her friends killed her? Well, guess what? Her parents is suing the hotel and shit she was at, too. They suing them, too. They finna get a big bag. Think they want $1 million or something from them over there. And guess what? They gonna have to pay. And with the stipulation how they gonna pay, they ain't gonna admit no guilt. They just go cash these people out and keep it moving. That's the main thing about when you take a lawsuit, is whatever the stipulations it is, if it's in writing, You got to honor that. And that means from now on, since we signed this check, you better not never say this person got killed over here and we was part of it. You better have a name or something. You can't just throw it up in the air like, man, you stayed at that hotel. Which one? You'll make them people lose their customers. Because people won't want to come there and pay tribute to their establishment if they know somebody got killed over here. No, people won't do it. They'll move around, go eat somewhere else. You know. Hit that like button, y'all. Subscribe to the channel, y'all. Subscribe to the channel. Do that right now. I'm going to give you time to do that, bro. Now, hit that subscribe button, y'all. Mm-hmm. And turn on your bell so you'll know whenever I drop some shit. I like to drop a video at 2 o'clock in the morning. And don't get mad. This one here, y'all, I'm sorry. It might be members only. You know why? Because y'all got to start joining the membership of this channel. You know, that's how you got to start doing that, because I need more members, so I got to start putting out some private videos. I'm sorry, but I have to. Also, I got the new merch just came out, y'all. So when y'all going through there, search through there, look and see something that you like. I said that my trucker, go on, see something you like. I got the truck driving hats. You got to change the colors on your own, y'all, because they just showing y'all pink. And they just showing white. But you can make the shirt any color you want. Just go through that, play with it, and it'll show you how it look in all colors. It'll show you how it look in all colors. My man from Bompton, I want you to get your red hat. Yeah, you better have that red hat. And send me a picture if y'all buy the shirt. If anybody buy merch, make sure you take a picture of it and send it to me, and I'm going to give you a shout out and, you know, let the people know, hey, my man, this is how the merchandise look anyway. This how it look anyway. And you know, I kind of like that when I got this one, y'all. You see the picture of me up there smiling? Yeah, I got that one. I had the other logo I had where I was just playing with it. It wasn't really nothing fancy. I just had put it on there to see how it worked. Because last time I made all them clothes and I couldn't get it going how I wanted to do. It was a lot, you know. I had shirts, everybody favorite baby daddy, G-Strump mugs and all that. That stuff's still over there at Wick. Is that Wick? Yeah, it's still over there. I might pull some of that up if I can, you know, just connect it. But I don't want to confuse nobody. I like this one right here, and I'm going to stick to that one until people start buying it, you know. I appreciate you for rocking with the show, y'all, you know. So, it's your boy G Shrimp, everybody, Faye Baby Daddy's Voice of the Street. I'm going to plant you now and dig you later. I'm out of here, man. So, make sure you go tell your mother, or tell a friend that G Shrimp is at it again. You hear me? I'm out.